If we had the common courtesy, the discipline, the patience, the skills to have enough trust and credibility with the people we're talking with so that they would share with us what they're really trying to achieve personally, professionally, short-term, long-term. If they share with us what they're really trying to achieve from a business standpoint, could we help them? Yes or no? Could we? So all we need to do is get them to share that with us. Because then we're not throwing stuff up against the wall. If I had more time, I'd play a game with you. I'd ask you to tell me all the things you sell. I'd say this. Give me the names of some of the things you sell. That's the way I trick people to give me the wrong answer. Give me the names of some of the things that you sell. And some people might say car insurance or life insurance or plumbing supplies or training or networking groups. That's not what you sell, is it?
No.
As a gateway computer manager, what I consider to be my last real job, when I was running a gateway computer store, my biggest challenge was to teach my team, my sales and support team, and my customers that we didn't sell computers. We didn't sell printers. We didn't sell training. We didn't sell service. We sold what our customers used those tools to actually achieve something. We helped our customers be more profitable, more effective, more efficient, and productive. Once you understand that, then you have a whole different perspective on your own value. But you need to understand it first before you start presenting stuff. But now that you understand that, then you can pick and choose. Whether you call it presenting solutions or teaching or selling, it's the same thing. It's helping that person understand why they should give you a chance. Why how you've helped other people in a similar situation and they should give you a chance. You're teaching more than anything else.